May I come in, sir?
Yes, come in.
Good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. Take your seat. Srushti Jayant Deshmukh.
Yes, sir.
Tell us something about you.
Sir, my full name is Srushti Jayant Deshmukh and I come from Bhopal. I'm an enthusiastic and determined girl. I have done my graduation in chemical engineering from Lakshmi Narayan College of Technology. And I recently completed my diploma in women's empowerment and development from the Indira Gandhi National Open University.
Okay. Why it is Srushti? We have heard of Srushti, but this is a very unique name, Srushti.
So in Marathi, the word Ri is pronounced as Ru. So that is why the pronunciation goes Srushti. So hereby the spelling, sir.
So you are basically an engineer. You have completed your engineering and thereafter you have developed interest in civil services.
Yes, sir.
What has inspired you to join civil services?
Sir, I believe that it is a job as dynamic as being a civil servant that will utilize all my capacities and capabilities. And it will be a journey to a life of large-mindedness where I will be able to care about other people's lives, their dreams, their passions, apart from my own.
What are the priorities you have thought of, priority areas where we'll be really doing a good work once you get selected?
So the first area which I am really eyeing is on education. I believe that India is coming up with a lot of children and youth. So skill training and education is something that we need to focus upon.
What are the problems being faced in education, particularly at the primary and secondary level in backward states like Uttar Pradesh and Bihar? Have you tried to analyze?
So the problems which I feel prominently is the quality of education. We have ensured that children come to school, but the quality of education that they are gaining, the learning outcomes, they need to be monitored the next. So this needs to be focused.
Suppose you are posted in a district of UP or Bihar where level of education is extremely poor, girl child, they are not given incentive to study. Those who study also, they leave midway. So what steps will you take to ensure that number one, they get quality education, and number two, they remain, they continue their studies and finish their school?
So the first point, I'll make sure that the teachers are attending the school properly. Teachers' attendance has been deterring these students from coming to school. And teacher training as well is equally important. Secondly, sir, the schemes like midday meal scheme have to be properly implemented so that students, like especially the young ones, can be attracted to come to school and they can come there.
Why teachers don't teach? And why there is such a poor quality of teachers?
Sir, I believe there's a lack of training of the teachers. They have done their basic qualifications, but they are not adequately trained is to ensure how learning outcomes have to be ensured. So we need to work on that front.
Okay. When you had to join civil services, why did you do your engineering course?
Sir,
I had... Don't you think it's a waste on your talent and waste on the... You have, in fact, taken a seat from somebody who could have pursued his engineering degree or her engineering degree?
Sir, the degree of chemical engineering is has provided me with a lot of knowledge and experience with regard to the field. Currently, the issues of environment and industrial safety are prime time in India as well. So I think this knowledge will help me in the civil services as well.
You have a passion for civil services from whatever little I have heard from you. But there is a perception that civil services is per se very corrupt. And it is divided on so many criteria, on caste lines, on some other considerations, and they have their own political affiliations also. It has not remained a steel frame which it used to be. So what is your take on this?
Sir, in a country as large as India and in a system, the bureaucratic system that we have developed for ourselves, there are bound to be challenges. Some, as you mentioned, of corruptness and otherwise irregularities or division on the basis of caste or otherwise. But I believe, sir, this should not deter the young aspirants who are believing to go into the system and try and be the as close to being the good civil servant and practicing values.
Your sister, you are very young. Don't you think that you are still too young to join civil services? You should gain some experience, try to know the country better way, in a better way, before joining the civil services and acquire more knowledge, so to say.
Sir, the very fact that UPSC allows us to sit for the examination at 21 years, I believe, is good enough a reason to try and sit for the exam. And I have worked on my front, studied what all I can to excel in this.
Okay, thank you.
Srushti, what do you know about C.D. Deshmukh?
Sir, C.D. Deshmukh was one of the first civil servants in the country. And he has also been the governor of the Reserve Bank of India. Sir, this much.
And what about Nanaji Deshmukh?
Sir, Nanaji Deshmukh was a very prominent social activist. Even a politician, he was active in the field of politics as well. And his works have been in the states of Uttar Pradesh, where he has worked for coalescing the different people and trying to bring the backward forward.
Who are the three personalities who have been awarded Bharat Ratna this year?
Sir, this year the recipients are the first Nanaji Deshmukh, then Shri Bhupen Hazarika, and Sir Shri Pranab Mukherjee.
Okay, no problem, Srishti. Srishti, you have just said that you have done a diploma in women empowerment, okay? Can you recollect some important judgments which have really empowered women in India?
Sir, I will start with the very recent one. In the Supreme Court, which allowed the entry to the Sabarimala temple, I believe it was a good step in the right direction, where the Supreme Court allowed the women to let their right to equal worship.
Any other judgment?
Sir, the Vishakha guidelines with respect to the harassment at the workplace.
That's very old. I am talking about the latest judgments. There are almost more than 10 latest judgments from Supreme Court and High Court.
So I'm unable to recall.
No problem. You are born in March, okay? So why the month of March is important for women empowerment?
Sir, I'll have to read on that, sir.
Okay. Yeah, you don't remember the importance of 8th of March?
I'm unable to
recall. No problem. You have done sociology, okay? What do you know about social mobility?
Sir, social mobility entails that in a given structure of the society, every society has a structure and a level of hierarchy. In any form, whether it is social or economic, when a person or a group is able to move from a higher to a lower or lower to a higher group, that could be termed as social mobility.
Okay. So do you think that reservation policy also leads to social mobility?
Yes, sir, it does. Reservation policy in terms of economic sense and also to the long term in the social sense, it can lead to social mobility.
Can you give me the example of some communities and also tribes who have achieved this mobility through reservation?
Sir, the Meena caste, which is there, a tribe which have now gained a social mobility to an extent.
Does the tribe, okay?
Yes, sir, it's a tribe.
Any other community? You belong to Madhya Pradesh, okay?
Sir, the Rajgond community has also.
Rajgond, they are from?
The tribe, sir.
They are from Madhya Pradesh?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Any other tribes in Madhya Pradesh?
Sir, who have gained social mobility.
What is intergenerational gap?
Sir, this term refers to the kind of intellectual or philosophical or other differences between two generations. They could be in the terms of ideas, in the terms of the traditions that they follow, or in the terms of the life that they experience.
Generally, what used to be the difference between the two generations, if we talk about the timeline? So, is it 15 years, 10 years, or something like that?
Sir, I'm not aware of the exact number.
Oh, you have not studied this.
Sir, I'm aware of the concept, but not of the years which you...
Okay. One more question, and that is regarding contribution of M.N. Srinivas. Tell me something about M.N. Srinivas.
Sir, M.N. Srinivas was a very prominent Indian sociologist. Mm-hmm. He tried to study the Indian society with Indian concepts. He tried to evolve certain parameters and certain concepts, the prominent one being Sanskritization.
Okay.
So, taking cue from the social mobility that you had asked, he says that with the help of Sanskritization, castes gain social mobility.
Mm-hmm.
Apart from that, his main contribution has been the popularization of field work in sociology.
Yeah.
He was the one who went to the villages and tried to understand the real picture of Indian villages, mm-hmm. and then tried to discern the condition of Indian society.
Okay. Last question. Generally, South India and Western India, it has witnessed many caste movements, but not North India. What is your take about this?
So, in the South India, there has been a direct clash between two castes, the upper and the lower one. In the North India, sir, there has been a proliferation of middle level castes. That has been a factor because of which a direct clash has not occurred. And I believe politically the middle caste factor has been taken advantage of, and that is why this direct clash we are not
seeing. Can you remember any caste movement from North India? Any caste movement?
So Yadavas have been active in politics, but...
Srushti.
Yes, sir.
Srushti, I'm sure you must be following international things nowadays.
Yes, sir.
If you look at the situation in Sri Lanka, what do you believe is the problem, internal problem in the Sri Lanka, especially the problem with the Prime Minister and the President? Do you believe that after this Tamil thing, they have created two power centers within Sri Lanka, both powerful, and that's why this separation of power thing has created an imbalance, and it will reoccur in future when the President and Prime Minister will not be on the same page.
Sir, I don't feel I have adequate knowledge to comment on that, sir.
Okay. Anyways, you took sociology as your discipline, and you studied in an engineering college, and you were part of the anti-ragging committee. Tell me, what is sociology of ragging? Are we actually a society of mob lynchers? Every time we get an opportunity, we actually mob lynch individuals. Ragging is one form of that. What do you say?
So I will not say that we are a society of mob lynchers. I will say there have been instances where mob lynching has come out as the immediate expression of the anger of people. But there have to be efforts in place where we can reduce the kind of spread. For example, sir, recently there have been such lynchings because of WhatsApp groups where people have forwarded the messages and just acted on that front.
Can you just go back to the ragging thing? What, in your opinion, is the sociology of ragging? Why do one rag?
So, if we go to the sociology of ragging, so I believe there is to some people, there could be a misguided sense of being superior, trying to prove themselves superior, or to bully the other person, and a sadist attitude to try to derive pleasure out of the other person's pain. I think, sir, this is the underlying...
You believe it's an individual trait, it has nothing to do with the collective
sense? Yes, sir. I believe it is an individual.
Usually the ragging take place, wherever ragging used to take place, and if it is taking place still, it is usually in groups. It is the group of seniors who actually rag a group of juniors.
Sir, then I'll say that it is an individual trait, but when like-minded people and students come together, they try to... behave in this certain manner.
You have taken some qualification in women empowerment.
Yes, sir, very recently.
You are a very young aspirant. Suppose you get into the civil services at this very attempt, and you reach the trainings. And in the academy, you feel that everybody is being very polite to you since you're very young. You're being kid-gloved in the entire training thing. And you're being patronized by not only your teachers, the trainers there, but even your colleagues who may be 8 years, 10 years senior to you in A's. How will you handle this situation when you're not getting equal footing in your, even in your training or in course of your civil services practice?
Sir, being kid-gloved, as you said, or being treated as such, would not be, in my opinion, an appropriate way to handle or behave to a person. So, sir, I'll try to put forward this to whoever people are, I feel, have been behaving with me in that manner. And I'll try to bring forth those capacities and capabilities in me.
But they're being extra nice. How can you say don't be extra nice to me? They're not harassing you. They're not being rude to you. They're just being extra nice.
Sir,
and it is obviously affecting your personality development over there, Abhya.
So that's what I will try to convince them, that it is good for my own personal growth that I be treated equally at par with all the other candidates. I'll make sure that I convey that to them.
You're basically a Marathi staying in Madhya Pradesh. Recently, Madhya Pradesh Chief Minister, when in the very first week, said that outsiders should not be claiming the jobs and opportunities in Madhya Pradesh. Obviously, he was not referring to Marathis as such, but Maharashtra is also guilty of similar behavior for the similar people. What is your take on this? Should this our land, our jobs, this protectionism have any place in federalism like ours?
I don't think so, sir. Every state has its own cultural traditions and own customs. But this does not mean that we deter other people from coming and participating in the employment or the education sector. I believe in the longer term, the politicians have to, and the government together has to move forward in creating employment and ensuring education facilities to all, so that we cannot transfer the blame of this on some other person who is migrating for his own reasons.
You. Okay, Ms. Deshmukh, so you have done chemical engineering, right?
Yes, sir.
Do you know what is plasma?
Sir, plasma is a fourth state of matter.
Okay, and why it is important nowadays?
So one application of plasma that comes to my mind is the water filtration, wherein plasma technique is useful. Sir, I'll read on that.
Okay, no issue. And you are interested in yoga and meditation?
Yes, sir.
Do you know about Vipassana?
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me something about that?
So Vipassana is a special technique, so to say, of meditation, wherein they have a routine of 7 to 10 days. It's like a camp or a shivir, which Vipassana organizers do. In that, they make us experience the different reactions that our body produces when we feel in certain ways. So when we think or feel in certain ways, our body reacts to it. This particular interface is targeted in Vipassana, and it is tried to make us understand our bodies and our minds better.
Have you gone to any such camps?
No, sir, I've not been.
Not yet. Okay, fine. What are your service preferences?
Sir, the Indian Administrative Service, then the Indian Police Services, Indian Revenue Service Income Tax, Indian Revenue Service Customs, and Indian Railway Traffic Service.
Okay, let me put you in a situation. Let's say you are an IPS officer, and in your city, there are two immediate situations which got arises. One is that there is a girls' college where some goons are basically planning to do acid attack. It is certain that they will do it because they have done it before also. And at the other part of the city, there is a mob lynching which is being planned. That is also certain. Now you are there, and if you have to, give a preference to one such incident where you will place yourself, then what would it be? Where you would like to go?
Sir, both the incidents in hand are really serious. The acid attack is abhorrent and deplorable, to say the least. And mob lynching can have a very deep impact. It can disturb the communal harmony or other such harmony of the social setting. Even if I'm not physically present in one particular area, I'll make sure that adequate steps are taken, Like in the girls' college, I'll make sure that
you would go. I mean, you cannot be present at the both situation at the same time. So what will be your preference? You can send your subordinate, but where you will place yourself?
So I'll take turns to visit both the places. I'll take turns to visit both the places.
But first, where you will go first?
So that would be dependent on the, the time of...
I mean, both the things are happening at the same time. You cannot time it.
So I'll go to a place where my personal presence can make a greater difference.
Where it
that will
make
depend it? On the operational... So I'll go to the place of mob lynching. Because
why?
I believe that in the case of acid attack, I can ensure that the subordinates can cordon off the area and take all the girls to a safer place. That is a task which is doable by a force and a subordinate who's responsible. In the area of mob lynching, I believe my personal presence can make a better difference.
What kind of difference it will make?
So first of all, I'll make sure that if the people are, people should not be on the streets or so to say in the run.
No, that is
even
a corrective measure
that,
you will take. What
yes,
kind of difference it will make by your presence?
So proper communication and...
Okay, fine. One more thing I have to ask. What is nanomaterials? What are nanomaterials?
Nanomaterials are the kind of materials in very recently discovered material technology, whose thickness is around 10 to the power minus 9 meters.
Is there any application of it which is there in a present life?
Yes,
any
sir.
Nanomaterial? Can you give example of?
Sir, scientists are working on the applications. There is a nanomaterial in which a very thin layer, like I mentioned, just 10 to the power minus 9, that much thick layer could become a conductor. Or with certain modifications, it could become an insulator. So this can have... a lot of applications in the space technology on
okay.
the very first front, sir.
Okay, fine.
Srushti, tell me, like, why is India keen on building libraries in Afghanistan when there are more serious issues?
So at this point in time, India has not committed itself to direct defense intervention. So we are working on the social sector front, where we can empower or support the education sector of Afghanistan. And libraries are a step in that direction, sir.
Okay. Are you aware that India has actually built any library in Afghanistan?
Sir, I'm aware of a library as well as the parliament building that we have built for Afghanistan.
Why is India not keen to talk with Taliban directly, though it is participating in non-official talks?
Sir, I'll read on that.
Okay. President Trump is following an America First policy. What implications does it have for India?
So India has good trade relations with America. We have a trade surplus with America. So in that case, if America First policy is adopted, then it can have an adverse impact on the Indian exports. And secondly, with regard to the visa, sir, as well as the service exports, even our IT professionals can suffer a setback if this America First policy is implemented.
Okay. What do you know about this VYAPAM? What is VYAPAM?
So VYAPAM is the state professional board for professional examinations.
Why has it been in news?
So it has been in news, unfortunately, for the very wrong reasons, that there were reports of irregularities. And in the case of examination, there were irregularities that the proper candidate who should be there in the examination hall was not there and somebody else was substituting for it.
Okay, this reservation of women in parliament, that bill has been pending for a long time. And there has also been demand from certain quarters that there should be quota within quota. What is your view?
Sir, looking at the present state of reservation and how it has panned out, a lot of factors show that the real people who need or require the reservation are not getting it. So a quota within a quota where we can reach, for example, in the women, we can reach the poorest of the poor women and the women who belong to the very lower castes. That could be a greater benefit.
So you support this quota within quota concept?
Yes, sir.
And what is your view on the reservation provided to general category? Is it a right step or is it a step in the direction of making reservation ineffective by providing it to everybody?
Sir, the movement of reservation from being caste-based to income-based is a positive one. But the as the implementation has taken 8 lakh as the ceiling. That in my mind, sir, covers the entire country, around 98% by recent surveys.
So don't you think so it is a good step to make it ineffective or to actually wipe out reservation in the long run?
So I think this will entrench reservation more, because no politician would risk the factor of removing reservations. So
okay, you are coming from Madhya Pradesh, and if you have to tell somebody to have a very protein-rich diet, what would you recommend coming from Madhya Pradesh?
So I'll recommend a special millet, kodo and kudki, which are very a tribal variety of millet, but very rich.
And if somebody is non-vegetarian, then?
So I'll recommend Kadaknath.
Okay, chicken. Thank you, sir.
You are from Habibganj. Habibganj station, this is most talked about station. What is so special about it, railway station?
Habibganj has been selected for the modernization in a private-public partnership by the Bansal Group. And it will be one of the first stations in the country to be developed in such a manner.
What is this world-class station?
So, world-class station, by the very word, we mean to match the international infrastructure. We also plan to have shopping complexes within the premises of the railway station, proper parking facilities, and proper services for the people who are travelling.
So, one last question to you. I'm giving a hypothetical situation.
All right, sir.
You are already a member of Indian Administrative Service. You are in a working post. You are known for your honesty and integrity. And people speak very good of you, about your fairness, about your balanced decisions, about your neutrality, everything, all good things about you. In the course of your work, you find that your subordinates start speaking about your family members. Somebody in your family is taking advantage of your position to make money in your name. How will you deal with this situation? And that person is so close to you, if you confront him or her directly, probably your family relationship will be greatly affected. How will you deal with this situation?
Sir, I have two situations in hand in this case. The first is that my professional image is at stake. I have, like you said, that it is that I have been working honestly. So I need to make sure that this image continues. Other side, as you said, that the family member is close to me. But I will make sure that I talk to the family member, however close it is, and try to make him understand this fact that no advantage should be taken in my name whatsoever.
But if he or she doesn't understand?
No, sir. I'll try to convince the person, and in case if the things really go out of control, I will also take some action, whichever suits lawfully.
Okay. Thank you very much, Srushti. Your interview is over.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you.
So, how was it?
Sir, it was really good.
Good.
Yes.
What is your assessment of your performance?
So I need to work on international affairs and a bit on facts as well. I need to work on, but it was better than what I thought. I'll be really nervous.
When is your interview?
I can handle that situation. So 21st of February.
21st of February. Okay.
Yes, sir.
The performance has been excellent.
Thank you, sir.
So plus point is that you are a very young girl. And UPSC or civil services, they really look forward to inducting such people. Catch them young theory, you must have heard.
Yes, sir.
So you can be molded to the working of nitty-gritties of government working. And if you get inducted now, you could go to the rank of cabinet secretary also. The age is on your side. Freshness is on your side. You are young, fresh, and a very pleasing personality. So honesty of purpose is there, patience is there in you. You have handled situational questions also very well, because board may like to put you under stress and try to see your reaction to those stress situations.
Yes, sir.
And as you have rightly pointed out, that you need to work on some international affairs.
Yes, sir, I do need
Then women empowerment, Yes, because it, strikingly, it comes to our mind.
Yes.
Sir, I, March, remind me.
International Women's Day, sir, wo takra ke ja raha tha, but wo sure nahi tha, isliye maine bola nahi, maine kaha agar
नहीं होगा तो नो इन द मेन इंटरव्यू
एंड सर सेकंड थिंग मुझे भी एक चीज पूछनी थी कि आई हैव नॉट मेंशनड दिस डिप्लोमा बिकॉज़ आई डिड नॉट गेट द सर्टिफिकेट
इसमें नहीं लिखा हुआ है
तो आई ट्राइड टू जस्ट पुट इट तो मैं आपसे मतलब शुड आई मेंशन दिस
मैं तो कहूंगा जो नहीं मेंशन करो
इफ यू हैव स्टडीड वेल इफ यू हैव डिफेंड इन एनी केस यू विल बी फेसिंग क्वेश्चंस ऑन वुमेन डेवलपमेंट एंड जेंडर इश्यूज सो एज सच देयर इज नो हार्म प्रोवाइडेड यू आर एबल टू डिफेंड इट I don't think you were prepared enough today, but if you are able to prepare, only then mention it. Otherwise, just let it.
The excellent performance, and there is no reason why you should not be a successful candidate. You'll come out with flying colors. That is our assessment of your interview, and do well.
Srushti, make sure that you sustain your performance. This is a problem at your age, and you're getting my point. You are doing really well. And from now on up to the date of interview, make sure that you're not letting this performance slide down.
Yes, sir.
Sustain it. And sustaining is as difficult as raising your information. Okay? So take care of that. You're not taking so many suggestions. You're not trying to implement every suggestion that you get. Hmm. You have to be very careful about that. Otherwise, you're doing perfect.
Be your natural self. Don't take too many suggestions from us. Okay? And because your interview has been fantastic. And you are a wonderful candidate for the board. So you will get very good marks at the interview. It all depends on how you have done your written and all that. But you have a bright future ahead. All the best.
I thank you, sir, for all your time. Thank you so much.
And don't go for each and every mock which is being offered around. Right? Because you are already there.
So, thank you so much, sir. Thank you.